Mr. Drew has much to do. You see, he is inspector number four. After work, he comes home to a life that he was hoping would be more. Sitting on a lounge chair on the deck in his backyard, he sips his wine. When a frisbee out of nowhere knocked the wine glass from his hand, oh, what a crime. Angry and frustrated, our victim throws the frisbee in the trash. Feeling he is free of trouble, sits back down to scratch his rash. On Tuesday, Mr. Reuben picks the trash up and he puts it in his truck. When from the corner of his eye he sees a thing that must be worth a buck. He sees a brightly colored disc just like the one he played with as a kid. He gets the nerve to bring it home to his discerning, loving wife, Enid. Enid took one look at it and flung it just as far as she could throw. The pain that she inflicted on our Mr. Reuben, she will never know. Mr. Drew sat on his lounge chair, sipping on another glass of wine. When suddenly a frisbee knocked the glass out of his hand a second time. Picking at the scab that was the rash he had a day or two ago. Mr. Drew was double mad and hurled the frisbee about a mile or so. It landed on a pile of leaves, but first gave a concussion to a crow. In 3 months' time, the mighty disc would be beneath the foot or two of snow. It happened that this heap of snow was in the yard of Madame Carazoo. In spring she found the frisbee picking ginkgo leaves for some exotic crew. There must have been a reason for this flying saucer to have come my way. I'll have to send this omen off to one who needs a blessing on this day. Mr. Drew sat on a lounge chair sipping on his precious glass of wine. When suddenly a frisbee knocked the glass out of his hand one final time. His jugular exploded as he hurled the frisbee out of his own view and had a cardiac arrest while that damn frisbee traveled here to Timbuktu. Inspectors number 1 through 3 arranged a funeral for number 4. They buried him beneath the dirt. We'll spare you all the gossip and the gore. Pooch the pup picked up the frisbee, played with it about a day or two, then buried it beneath a patch of earth located next to Mr. Drew.